Welcome to the first week of this massive open online course on PLSQL Fundamentals. You are viewing the first video of this week, getting started with week 1. In order to understand the concepts to be discussed in week 1 effectively, you are expected to have a good knowledge and exposure to structured query language and relational database management system concepts before taking up this course. You should have a fair idea of how data is stored in a relational database management system and the related terminology to interpret entity relationship or ER diagrams. You should have worked with the basic SQL objects like schema, tables, views, and sequences. You should have written and executed DDL, DML, and DCL statements in SQL. You should have familiarity with single row functions, date, conversion, and group functions in SQL. The objective of this week is to enable you to write simple PLSQL programs either as a single block or with nested PLSQL blocks in them. Each video in this course refers to a real-world scenario related to a hypothetical application called HR administration system. Jill, an application developer in an organization, tries to build the HR administration system using Oracle PLSQL. In this journey, she explores many features of PLSQL, each of which is explained in detail in each video. This course is presented in the form of small videos organized into 3 lessons. Each lesson is released each week consecutively. The first lesson, named Introducing Oracle PLSQL, consists of 7 videos in total. After you get an overview of lesson 1, the video titled Getting to Know Oracle Cloud provides you with a high-level introduction to the various cloud services that Oracle offers. You will have a quick tour of one of the Oracle Cloud services that allows you to create a connection from Oracle SQL Developer and execute SQL statements. The next video provides you with a background about PLSQL, including what it is and why it is needed in real-world applications. You will learn about its various features and benefits. Later, you will learn with the help of a runtime architecture diagram how PLSQL blocks are actually executed. You will get introduced to block structure and learn about the different types of PLSQL blocks. The next video explains the various data types supported by PLSQL. You will learn how to declare and use PLSQL variables and bind variables with the help of code examples. The next video introduces you to different lexical units such as identifiers, delimiters, literals, and comments used in PLSQL so that you can write executable statements in PLSQL blocks. Towards the end of this module's videos, you will learn about nested blocks and how to determine the scope and visibility of variables in nested blocks with detailed code examples. You will be provided with homework assignments at the end of a few videos as applicable, so that you can solve them to gain a better practical exposure to Oracle PLSQL. If you have questions regarding homework assignments or are stuck while doing the homework, you can collaborate with us and your course students via the course forum to get the help. Looking forward to your wholehearted participation this week. Thank you. Have a great day.